Hello everyone. You might have felt the power of wind. You may have also seen the trees swinging in the wind. So what actually wind is? Now you will say that the flow of air is wind. So what actually makes this air flow, and why is this flow more at some places and less at some places? So let's find out. Now to find out, let's consider an area. Let's consider this area and that area. Let's assume that sun rays are falling only on this area 1 and not on area 2. So what will happen? After some time, you will find out that this area 1 will get heated up. And as this area gets heated up, the air around this area will get warm. And as the air becomes warm, you know very well that warm air rises up in the sky. So the air around this area, area 1, will start rising upwards, and hence a low pressure zone will be created in this area 1. Now if you look at area 2, the area 2 is not receiving any sunlight. So air around that area will be colder in nature, and since the air around this area 2 is colder, hence it will stay on the ground only, and hence a high pressure zone will get created in this area 2. So you know that air always flow from high pressure zone to low pressure zone. So what will happen now? Air from this high pressure zone will rushes towards low pressure zone, and hence a wind will be formed. Now this effect is very much prevalent near the shores. The land gets heated up at a much faster rate than the sea, and hence there creates a low pressure zone on the land and a high pressure zone on the sea. So what happens? The air starts flowing from the higher pressure zone, that is from the sea, to the land, as land has low pressure zone. So this happens in the morning time, but in the night time the land cools at a much faster rate than the sea. So what will happen? A high pressure zone will be created on the land this time, and a low pressure zone will be created on the sea. So the movement of the air flow will be from land to the sea. So we can say that the air flow is from sea to land during the daytime and from land to the sea during the night times. Wind energy has been utilized by many civilizations to do many things. Sailors used to sail their boat in the ocean by using the wind energy. Then it was used by the windmill to draw water from the wells and also to grind the flour. You also must have used the wind energy to dry your clothes. And now we can use the energy of the wind to make electricity. Now this purpose is served by using a windmill. Now the basic principle here is the same as of every power plant. The turbine rotates the generator and electricity is being produced. We always require something to rotate the turbine. So what happens? We connect the turbine to the windmill, and as the wind strikes the blades of the windmill starts rotating, and hence the turbine and the generator rotates and we get electricity. Now do you know that Denmark is known as country of winds? More than 25% of the electricity needs of the whole country is being generated by a vast network of windmills. Now in terms of power output, Germany leads the world and India ranks 5th in the total power generation by windmills. Now it is estimated that if India could fully utilize its wind potential, it could generate around 45,000 megawatts of energy by using windmills. The wind energy is an efficient and environment friendly source of renewable energy. Then also there are some limitations of wind energy. Some of the limitations you can also guess. Now you must know that the wind don't flow at all times. Plus its speed also vary at different times. So we have a limitation that we can set up the windmill at only those places where the flow of wind is continuous and its speed don't vary that much. Now we also know that the assembly of windmills is a very costly thing, and hence the setup of a windmill or wind farm is very costly thing. Hence it is very expensive to set up a wind farm. And their last limitation is that the blades of the windmill are exposed to sun, rain, storm and cyclones, and hence they need a higher level of maintenance, which increases additional cost to the setup of the windmill.